Miguel and his wife Ada are retired and live near the airport in West Miami, Florida. In January 2016, the elderly couple were 89 and 83 years of age, respectively, and they very, very much enjoyed the company of Gucci, their beloved three-year-old Chihuahua, and treated him as one of the family. So naturally, the Rojas were utterly devastated when their time with Gucci was tragically cut short. Ada had been walking with their pet in the local neighborhood on Thursday, January 8th, when they came across two aggressive American Bulldog mixes on the loose. One of the larger stray dogs mauled the 5-pound Chihuahua viciously as Ada and some of her neighbors tried desperately to fight the attacker off. Sadly, despite their best efforts, by the time the unprovoked assault was over, Gucci was fighting for his life. Miguel was summoned to recover the poor Chihuahua, and he bundled the dog up and rushed him back home. However, Miguel's heightened emotions led to a rise in his blood pressure, and soon the old guy was in serious trouble too. In fact, when Miguel reached his address, he suffered a mild heart attack and the emergency services were called. Miguel's daughter, Ada Rojas Jr., spoke to local TV channel WPLG about the incident the day after it happened. She recalled, "He just cuddled the dog, ran all the way back to the house and started crying, crying, crying until, I guess, he had the heart attack." Tragically, little Gucci was not strong enough to survive the attack. Not that his elderly owners escaped the ordeal unscathed. As well as Miguel's woes, Ada suffered injury to her arm in the efforts to rescue her beloved pet from the crossed canine. As a result, the retiree needed some 100 stitches to fix the damage. Meanwhile, Miguel was in safe hands and recovering from his minor cardiac episode at South Miami Hospital. His blood pressure was stabilized, but there was nothing they could do for what ailed Miguel most, a broken heart. Nothing could comfort the old man after the terrible loss of his poor little pet. The attack on Gucci was so shocking that word of it soon began to spread on social media. The online community was also concerned about how devastated the Rojas were over the appalling death of their dog. And later that same day, the news was picked up by local television news crews. In fact, it was on TV that Thursday evening that a kind stranger learned about the Rojas' loss, and the shockingly sad story began to turn around. Local viewer Mario Combo decided to make a difference. "I saw the story yesterday and right away I said I needed to do something, and I did something because this broke my heart," he told regional broadcaster CBS Miami. "From the bottom of my heart, this story broke me up." With that in mind, Combo contacted specialist breeders, the Wee Puppy Paws Kennel in Homestead, South Miami, in an effort to make things better for Miguel and Ada. He told the facility's owner, Lynn Broderick, about his thoughtful intention to purchase the couple a replacement puppy, and it touched the woman's heart. The dog breeder decided that she would like to help as well. As a result, Broderick sold Combo a baby Chihuahua at a half-price discount of $300. She told CBS Miami that she had knocked so much money off the bill because the story of Gucci's death and the Rojas' loss affected her so much. "It just broke my heart, and I wanted to do something," Broderick revealed. But it was Bina Fink Cole, a friend of the Rojas family, who delivered a 9-week-old Chihuahua to their door on Friday, January 9th, just one day after Gucci had passed. Thankfully, Miguel had been released from South Miami Hospital in time for the surprise. Needless to say, the Rojas were overwhelmed by the stranger's act of kindness. Miguel in particular, he just could not control his tears as he took the puppy into his arms. Nonetheless, they were tears of sorrow as well as tears of joy, despite the emotional Miguel lifting the new arrival to his face and crying out, "Contento." Later, he told a CBS Miami reporter, "I am happy," but he added that he was also sad. And bearing in mind what the old guy had been through in the previous 24 hours, it was hardly surprising that he was suffering from mixed emotions. However, Ada was quick to add that the new Chihuahua puppy, soon to be called Willie, had given the elderly couple hope in their darkest hour. "We felt Gucci's death very big, and this dog made us want to continue to live," she explained to the TV reporter. "We did not feel like living. God has given us a gift." Ada Jr. was also overcome with bittersweet emotions. "I am numb with happiness and I am numb with pain to see my father suffering tremendously since the puppy deceased yesterday," she told the crew from WPLG. The daughter also insisted, "They are family. They're not animals. They are family." She went on to add, "If someone came and offered me $1 million, I don't want it. I don't want the $700 million lottery. We don't want any of it. We just received unconditional love from my parents. I don't want any money. To me, what's going on right now, I'm already a winner. As Willie settled into his new life in the Grateful Rojas household, the dogs who had attacked Ada and caused Gucci's death were experiencing much less comfortable accommodation. Both stray American Bulldog mixes had been successfully seized by the Miami-Dade Animal Services Department. Indeed, Lillian Bajorquez, a communications officer for the local government agency, assured WPLG that the male and female animals were safely under lock and key. She revealed that the male mutt was found to have a microchip fitted. However, the department had been unable to contact the owner. Since this dog had not been directly involved in the killing of Gucci, it was likely he would be released if his owner came forward. But Bajorquez said it was a different story for the female American Bulldog mix. She was not microchipped and her owner had not made themselves known. The female had been solely responsible for the fatal attack on Gucci. Consequently, following a time limit of 10 days in quarantine, the animal faced the prospect of being put down for her actions. Nevertheless, it had turned out to be less of a sad ending for the Rojas retirees, thanks to the kindness of strangers. Although Miguel and Ada may never forget their dear Gucci, they were now looking forward to a future with Willie. As Ada Jr. told WPLG, "We lost one of our family members, but this is going to allow my father today to sleep and maybe he will feel a little bit better."